Grace and peace to you from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. Today's reading is from A.W. Tozer, 1897 to 1963, and it's from his book, The Knowledge of the Holy. Today's reading focuses on God's infinite nature. Because God's nature is infinite, everything that flows out of it is infinite also. We poor human creatures are constantly being frustrated by limitations imposed upon us from without and from within. The days of the years of our lives are few and swifter than a weaver's shuttle. Life is short and a fevered rehearsal for a concert we cannot stay to give. Just when we appear to have attained some proficiency, we are forced to lay our instruments down. There is simply not enough time to think, to become, to perform what the constitution of our natures indicates we are capable of. How satisfying to turn from our limitation to a God who has none. Eternal years lie in his heart. For him, time does not pass. It remains, and those who are in Christ share with him all the riches of limitless time and endless years. God never hurries. There are no deadlines against which he must work. Only to know this is to quiet our spirits and relax our nerves. For those out of Christ, time is a devouring beast. Before the sons of the new creation, time crouches and purrs and licks their hands. The foe of the old human race becomes the friend of the new, and the stars in their courses fight for the man God delights to honor. This we may learn from the divine infinitude. But there is more. God's gifts in nature have their limitations. They are finite because they have been created, but the gift of eternal life in Christ Jesus is as limitless as God. The Christian man possesses God's own life and shares his infinitude with him. In God, there is life enough for all and time enough to enjoy it. Whatever is possessed of natural life runs through its cycle from birth to death and ceases to be. But the life of God returns upon itself and ceases never. And this is eternal life. To know the only true God and Jesus Christ, whom he has sent. Our prayer is also from the knowledge of the holy. Let us pray. Our Heavenly Father, let us see thy glory. If it must be from the shelter of the cleft rock and from beneath the protection of thy covering hand, whatever the cost to us in friends, in loss of friends, or goods, or length of days, let us know thee as thou art, that we may adore thee as we should, through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.